What an interesting phone call. My security manager, James, just got a hold of our government contacts. They told him that we were not scheduled for an inspection today. And since you are not on the guest list, James doesn't know who you are. But I do. It's obvious. You're a journalist. It fits. Your kind always go to such extremes for your stories. I would like to remind you that freedom of the press does not extend to trespassing. We'll have a talk once you get out. A journalist. I've had my fair share of experience with your kind. Always trying to make me show a sign of weakness. So let this be a reminder. I have none. I really enjoy seeing a door being slammed in your face. Thank you. Since you're a journalist, you must be here to investigate the merits of Arthur's accusations. Yes, I read the papers. I like to keep myself misinformed. Do you know what makes his lies so convincing? The small amount of truth he uses. Yes, light matter caused hair loss and other minor side effects. But I solved all of that with the mineral decontaminators. What did Arthur do? He poisoned our employees, exaggerating those side effects in his crusade to destroy me. Jealousy can be so ugly. It can be so all-consuming. It consumed our partnership, it consumed our friendship, and it almost destroyed this entire facility. Journalist, Arthur's poison project severely damaged morale. My employees weren't just losing their hair, they were losing their identity. So besides installing the decontaminators, I ordered a container full of wigs. It was a success. Everyone started using them, except me. I don't try to cover up facts. Lost my leg. Before the facility, Arthur and I were climbing this mountain as it started shifting around us. The quakes mangled my leg beyond recognition, and that coward left me there to die. But I went deeper into the mountain and came back with a photon crystal. Add that to your article. Thank you. You know, when Arthur started working against me, I needed loyalty. I found that in James, a miner who crawled his way up the food chain. Not the brightest, but the most dedicated. Don't let his title as security manager distract you from his role as my right-hand man. So, journalist, you will soon be out of here. But before you write a hit piece about the quote-unquote deadly shadows of light matter, let's get the facts straight. The shadow anomalies are not spreading beyond the facility. They are local to the core. Also, we have had countless test runs on the core before today, and there have never been any signs of shadow anomalies. There is a simple explanation for that. You see, my engineers desperately strive to impress me. So during the launch event, one of them turned up the core's energy output. Understand, for every 100 megawatts I spend powering the core, I normally receive 107 megawatts. And today, that number increased to 111 megawatts. But I take full responsibility for my engineer's wrongdoing. I'm finding a solution, and he's finding a new career. Actually, he's probably dead. When you write about these shadows, be mindful of the words you choose. What changes nuclear power from a weapon to an energy source? Words. Think about that, journalist. You found the employee handbook, written by me. Let me give you a quote. Before anything else, preparation is the key to success. End quote. Thank you. You see that picture? My employees had a joke once. They made a poster that named James as the employee of the month. I liked the idea, so I had a bigger one printed. Journalist, you must admit that the shadow anomalies are fascinating. Think about the applications. Organic waste disposal, mold removal, pest control. The possibilities are endless. Thank you. Are you afraid of the dark? I'm not. Of all the fears I've tamed, from darkness to clowns to death, taming them made me stronger. These shadows could make the whole world stronger, force them to face their fear of darkness, and become more like me.